Hello students, welcome to the world of biology through Jaguar classes. Today I am starting the first session of this academic session 2020-21 with the introduction of the biology syllabus that I am taking in this session. First of all, I want to introduce you that I am taking my first session of this series, which is based on the unit 2, World of Living, and in this I will cover chapter 6, Life Process. In this chapter, topics to be covered are living beings, basic concept of nutrition, basic concept of respiration, basic concept of transpiration, basic concept of excretion. During the whole chapter, we will cover up these main topics, but in first session of this chapter or first part of this life processes class, I will cover mainly these subtopics. One is living beings and their fundamental characteristic, metabolism or life processes. The another subtopic is significance of diffusion in context of fulfilling the requirements of multicellular organisms. Side by side, we will take nutrition as the life process and types of nutrition in organisms. In this, I will start with a little bit about the photosynthesis, but I will cover the detail of that in next chapter. Before starting my chapter, I want to share with you the learning outcomes of this class. After this class, all of you will be able to define life processes, metabolism, catabolism, and anabolism. You will be able to explain insignificance of diffusion in multicellular organism, due to which organ and organ systems have been evolved in multicellular organisms. You will be able to define the process of nutrition as well as nutrients, and you will be able to describe the different modes of nutrition, differentiate between autotrophic and heterotrophic nutrition. Side by side, these knowledge-based learning outcomes, you will be able to gain the skills and competencies related learning outcomes. These are analytical skills by scrutinizing and observation, critical thinking by competitive evaluation of the given information, and problem solving ability to understand complex concepts. First of all, I will start with my recalling session, in which I will ask some of the questions related with this chapter which you have already learned in class 7th and class 9th. My first question is, what criteria do we use to decide whether something is alive or dead?
Yes ma'am, I know the answer for this. The criteria used are, major criterion is movement, that includes locomotion, yes, action of body parts, yes, breathing, growth, yes, maintenance and repair of cellular structures, etc. Another is performing of life processes,
yes.
Then we have respiration, display, yes, of growth and development, and as well as excretion.
Very good. Now my second question is, what processes would you consider essential for maintaining life?
Ma'am, I think there are 6 processes which are considered to be essential for maintaining life.
Can you list them?
Those are nutrition,
mm-hmm,
respiration,
mm-hmm,
transportation,
mm-hmm,
excretion,
mm-hmm,
and control and coordination.
Very good. Now, my third question is, what is diffusion?
Diffusion is the movement of molecules from a high concentration region to a lower concentration.
Very good. Can you now tell that why this diffusion process is insufficient to meet the oxygen requirement of multicellular organism as compared to unicellular organism?
Ma'am, let's do it by comparing unicellular and multicellular organism.
Okay.
In a unicellular organism, there is single cell present, which is in contact with the surrounding environment.
Yes.
But unlike in the multicellular organism, not all cells are in contact with the surrounding environment.
Yes.
Which prevents the transportation of oxygen molecules through diffusion to all the cells.
Yes.
And it is restricted to the outer cells only.
Excellent. Excellent.
Also, it is estimated that it will take 3 years for an oxygen molecule to reach our toes from our lungs.
Very good.
Through the
Very
process
good.
Of diffusion.
That means now we can decide that you are ready to learn this chapter further more. Now, in this chapter, first of all, I will start with that metabolism, which is a new term for you, but it is simply the summation of all the life processes. That means all the life processes in living organism together known as metabolism. We can also tell them biochemical processes and physiological processes that you will study in higher classes. Now, that metabolism is actually of two types, according to which we are classifying all the life processes into anabolic and catabolic type of life processes. Anabolism, in which synthesis of complex molecules from simpler ones is taking place. But on the other side, catabolism is breaking of complex molecules into simpler ones. For example, in case of anabolic life processes, we can consider the nutrition process in plants, that is photosynthesis, in which plants are taking carbon dioxide and water, which are the simpler molecules, and they convert them into starch or glucose by the process of photosynthesis. On the other side, in catabolism or catabolic life processes, we can consider the example of nutrition process in animals, because in animals, the complex food substances are taken in and then they are breaking down and then converted into simpler ones. Side by side, respiration process can be also considered as catabolic reaction. Okay, now is it clear? Today, in this chapter, first we will take the life process nutrition. Nutrition as a life process, basically the word which is derived from the nutrients, and this is basically derived from the Latin language word nutrix, that means nurse. And this process can be defined as the process of taking in food and using it for growth, metabolism and repair. There are different types of nutrition. First of all, we are categorizing the nutrition process into two main types, and in class 9th you have also studied about the autotrophs and heterotrophs, and according to that classification of the living organism also has been done. And now we want to discuss what is actually the autotrophic and heterotrophic nutrition. What is the basic difference between these two types of nutrition process? As you know, autotrophic nutrition basically refers to the process of nourishing by which organisms make their food from simpler inorganic substances like carbon dioxide and water. On the other side, heterotrophic nutrition refers to the process of nourishing by obtaining food from other organisms either from plants or from other animals. The second point we can use to differentiate these two modes of nutrition. First, such organisms which are taking their nutrition or which are doing their nutrition process by the autotrophic mode of nutrition are called autotrophs, and basically in this category green plants are coming. And those organisms which are heterotrophic, or they are doing their nutrition by the heterotrophic process, are considered as heterotrophs. Means heterotrophs are the word that is used for the organisms, and heterotrophic is word which is used for the process. Now in the third point, we can consider that autotrophic nutrition is basically taking place by photosynthesis, but in some of the cases it is also taking place by chemosynthesis, like in some of the bacteria that we will discuss later on. And in heterotrophic mode of nutrition, there are three modes of nutrition: holozoic, saprophytic and parasitic. Parasitic, in later classes you will again study as in detail ectoparasites and endoparasites. Now, as I have told you, today I will focus on different modes of heterotrophic nutrition first. And in this, as just now I have told you, there are three modes: holozoic nutrition, saprophytic nutrition, which is also known as saprophytism, and parasitic nutrition, which is also known as parasitism. Now, first of all, we will differentiate among them. First point, that is definition level, we can clear them as holozoic nutrition, in which the organisms feed by ingesting solid organic matter, which is then digested and absorbed into their bodies by their digestive system. But in case of saprophytic nutrition, saprophytes or saprophytic organism feed on dead and decaying matter, which digests the food externally before the nutrients are absorbed by their body. Means here the digestion is taking place outside the body, and in case of holozoic nutrition, digestion is taking place inside the body. Or we can say that here in holozoic nutrition, intracellular digestion, but in case of that saprophytes, there is extracellular digestion. In case of parasitic nutrition, parasite organisms obtain their nutrients from other living organisms by living on or inside their body, and that organism inside which they are living is known as host, or on which they are living is known as host. Now come to the examples to understand these three terms. In case of holozoic nutrition, we can consider the example of humans, other animals and some insectivorous plants also. That means all green plants, besides phototrophic nutrition, some of the green plants going for this holozoic nutrition also, or heterotrophic nutrition also. You have already learnt in class 7th also about such type of plants, like pitcher plant is one type of that plant, which is taking place their nutrition by the that heterotrophic nutrition. Now, in case of saprophytic nutrition, you can consider the example of bacteria and fungi, which are doing the decomposition process, and that's why they are also known as decomposers in our ecosystem, which are doing the saprophytic nutrition by decomposing dead and decaying organic matter. In case of parasites, we can consider the two types: ectoparasites, which are living on the body of the host, like leech, fleas and lice. Ticks on dogs also can be considered as that. And tapeworm, Ascaris, roundworm, these are the helminths which are living inside the host body and considered as endoparasites. There are certain plant parasites also, means some plant are also adopting this mode of nutrition, like cuscut, which is generally known as amarbale. You have seen so many times these plants which are moving around, the different plants in yellow color, that climbing plant is known as cuscut plant or amarbale. Now come to the next part, that is showing the different modes of autotrophic nutrition. Means autotrophic nutrition, that in earlier part we have discussed, that of also two type, photosynthesis and chemosynthesis. Now here are the some point related with these two terms, which are in which photosynthesis you have already studied, but chemosynthesis is a new word for you. Now try to understand it. Photosynthesis, as you know, is the process in which plants or green plants or autotrophs synthesizes organic compounds by the energy obtained from the sunlight. While in case of chemosynthesis, the autotrophic process of making food, in which organism synthesizes the organic compounds in the cell by the energy generated from chemical reaction of certain inorganic or organic compounds. In case of photosynthesis, energy source is sunlight, but in case of chemosynthesis, energy source is the chemical energy which is stored in inorganic chemicals. And third point we can consider as, in photosynthesis there are certain pigments are required, like chlorophyll and other carotenoids pigments are also involved in this process, but there is no requirement of pigments in case of chemosynthesis. Now with that we have completed today's lecture, that is basically based on the mode of nutrition and basics of the nutrition process. You can sum up all these points by these three important points that we have studied throughout the class. First point is the ability to perform the basic life processes distinguishes a living organism from a non-living one, which are known as life processes. And all life processes are the vital processes carried out by living organisms in order to maintain and sustain life, and molecular movements are essential to carry out the various life processes in the living organisms. And side by side we have also learned that energy required to carry out the different life processes is obtained from carbon based food through the process of nutrition. That means nutrition process is one of the essential life process which is deriving the energy from the various food sources. And with that I will end my class here. My favorite quote that is here, I want to share with you. In this time of crisis, some breakdown, some breakthrough, the difference is attitude rather than aptitude. Your attitude, not your aptitude, will determine your altitude. Dear students, you can download the notes and assignment of this session from the link given in the description box below.